Well, today I come bearing nothing but good news. That's it. Today is the good news day. Pop the confetti, smack the TVs around. Well, except for the whole Russia saying that they're gonna do it. You know, that whole nuke thing. They are saying that they are serious and lending crashes. Mass layoffs begin. Cue the fire. Also, my apologies for the stock market. Didn't see that one coming. Also, if you wait to the end, I am going to explain to you, based on charts, how it is going to get a hell of a lot worse. And guess what is predicting it? And no, it is not Bitcoin, but yes, I will cover that also. It would actually be the bond market, but everyone gets so confused with that, so I try to like leave that one alone. Also, kill the fire number two. My apologies for Tesla, but look, you know, remember the E thing, that exit prior to earnings? You probably should have. It's like women and romance. Gentlemen, exit prior to child support. I mean, it's all fun and games until you start losing a whole lot of money. And here we go, starting with Wells Fargo. Layoffs, mass layoffs. And it's gonna be, you can't have what I'm gonna show you at the end of the video happening and not have this. I am so sorry. And if you're in the lending business, my apologies also. I think I'll be doing a lot of apologies this year. Layoffs hit Wells Fargo home lending unit as mortgage rates climb and originations plummet. But this is such a no-brainer. Look, when your revenue falls by 33% in the first quarter, you gotta do some firing. I'm sorry, bye-bye. Yes, Bravo, but that's Wells Fargo. What are you sure? That's just one. Okay. How about the country's largest lender? That would be Rocket Mortgage to trim workforce as home loan market shrinks. Thank you, Candace. And I'll tell you, gentlemen, the shrinkage is only gonna get worse. Well, that just depends on what side of the ruler you measure on. See, when I first met my wife, the first thing she said was, how big? And I said, well, it goes past the eight. And then she said, goes past the eight on what? Like, really kind of pushing the envelope. I said on a wooden ruler, it goes past the eight. And if you want to know the correct measurement, it says CM, correct measurement. That's where you want to measure. Oh, and just in case you want to know how much people make selling rule, don't sell one. That makes no sense. Look at that. A pack of 72 to do, that's the serious measurements. It's like, why sell small houses when you can sell really big, expensive houses? It's like the same amount of work. Go sell over there. Don't sell over there. Oh, don't do this one. This guy's only making $1,481.22 a month. Oh, and before I forget, thank you to you guys, my audience. In the comments section, you're like, why isn't anyone talking about HSBC? So if that was you, I was like, oh my gosh. So HSBC, because we're talking banks, we're talking lending, we're talking how this whole economy, oh no, down 7.5% today. Yikes, they're shelving just about everything. Buybacks. You know what's bad? When they're not even buying back their own stock. And oh my gosh, banks, it's only going to get worse. Big U.S. banks get a little taste of the doom loop. And now I must show you how it is going to get worse as you look above my head and all you see is a sea of red. No, Bravo, it can't get worse, but yes, it can. And here, let me show you based on using one chart and two lines. Now, before I show you this, you need to clear out your brain and go, okay, I don't know anything. Now, for me, that's very easy because I got like two things in there. So just one of you guys has to go. Now, looking at this chart, would you not say that those are correlated, right? That means when one goes up, the other one goes up. When one goes down, the other one goes down. Would you not agree with me since all the way back to the 80s, that these lines match up perfectly? And if you were to say yes, I would give you a big smiley face on your paper and give you an A. Now, the first line, this little light green line right there, that's the Fed's fund rate. That's where everyone gets really scared. They're like, oh my gosh, look at that thing move, right? That's 0.25, hasn't even moved yet. And now I'm gonna tell you a little secret that no one will ever tell you. Well, maybe. I mean, the news won't. This blue line, that's the bond market. And the Federal Reserve, right, that private bank that everyone says is the boogeyman, always follows that blue line, as you can see, going back to the 80s, unequivocally, perfectly. Now, what the media and what the Fed and what the government ever, and no one even understands the Fed, no one understands the bond market, no one understands the correlation. So that's why you click like. So I keep doing these videos for you so you can do more gooder in the stock market and be more better than everybody else. So let me show you by these lines what is going to happen. You're not going to like this in the stock market. You're not going to like this in your portfolio. The Fed always follows the two-year yield. And yes, it looks like they're in control, but I guarantee you they control nothing. But in school, they will tell you, like Jerome is God, right? It's like, that's the devil. Now maybe I've triggered something. So again, remove everything. Did you remove everything out of your head to look at the correlation? And also, just to let you know, the people that understand the bond market, they know how this thing works. I've tried to explain this slowly over and over on my channel because everyone wants to believe that the Fed's the devil and they Fed go burr, right? Very easy. I wish it was that easy, but hold on. I have not hit the juicy part just yet. It's getting there. See, the light blue line is the Fed's fund rate. It isn't up here yet now, is it? But it's going to be. And how do I know this? Because 100% of the time, since the 80s, they have followed the two-year yield. So this little line is going to go all the way up here. Now, if doing that crashes your beauty pageant, which I call a stock market, well, then be prepared. Because for some reason, when the Fed speaks, right? They teach you that in school. Good stuff. Don't fight the Fed. Believe everything that the Fed has to say. So they even mention a quarter of a point. Your lovely beauty pageant sells off. So yes, right now, yields are already up there. Guess what's not? The Fed. And they will, because they've done it every single time and it gives them the sense of control. And so everyone thinks it's the Fed that saved the market. You want to know what saved the market last time? Trillions of dollars. Things like the CARES Act, which you have to pay back in your taxes. I'm so sorry. But back to the two lines. Okay, the little blue teal one hasn't gone up yet. That's going to go up. The Fed is going to do it because they've always followed forever and ever the two-year yield. So that one is going to go up. And if it scares you that they're going to do that, and if you think that a half a point, a full point, all of the points, quarters of a point is going to crash the market, then it's going to crash the market. And you're going to sit there and you're going to click the sell button over and over and over and over again. Now, as a chartist, I think it's going to be a really hard time looking at this chart. That's your highest high. That's a lower high. That's a lower high. That's a lower high. That's a lower high. Do you see? You know, like, it's going to be really difficult to keep on a moving. I mean, not to say that it won't, but I'm just saying, as the chart shows you, it's not going to stay there for very much longer, and then it's going to break and I'm going to make money, which I already am set up to do. And now the confusion, because people don't understand how any of this works. Treasury yields fall. Wait, they're supposed to go up. What is going on as economic slowdown fears mount? And actually, this was published today. So maybe Bravo does know what the frack he's talking about. But then you guys, or if you're in Texas, y'all, you're confused because you're like, wait. But the Fed's going to raise rates, so rates have to go up, even though the Fed doesn't have control of them. They just want to perceive like they do. And everyone that I have ever met believes they do. And that's okay, because I'm going to be different. And also, if you're like, you know what, I disagree. Well, good. Let's disagree. It's good to follow a channel that you disagree with. But then I think after a while, you're like, shoot. So watch this happen. Watch yields, right, start to top and come down. And the Fed's like, oh, Gotta chase that 2 year. Let's look like we're in control here. Okay, but now on to the stock market and on to crypto to answer the question, why, Bravo? Why is Bitcoin going down? Why is the S&P 500? It's because of this blue line right here. And if you are currently in my CSU course, you already know. You know how to draw it. You know how to trade it. And also, before I forget, I never mentioned that I have that, because you guys were asking, can you give us everything you got and break it into monthly payments? And I said yes, but I never talk about it. 197, I think. Three payments. You get everything. My goodness gracious. Then you could know how to sell a ruler and start a business, right? That's what you do. It's a link in the description. I'll put that up today. Grab it, and then maybe I'll delete it because I think it's way too cheap. I think it's $197. Come on. My college courses are like $6,000 a piece. Why is my wife looking for things like this? This is what scares. You guys see all the things that I order. Now you know what I use to shave my face. Why? We don't need these. Champagne flute. For the love of Buddha. No. How much do, if you sell a champagne flute, do you make a month? Hopefully better than rulers that I measure with. $38,000, $288 a month. And here, let me give you the course in under 10 seconds. I copy this, insulated champagne flute. They make $40,000. I head over to Alibaba. I click paste. I buy it for $1.95. But also don't think it's easy, because it's not. Yeah, we have some shipping problems right now. And then I sell it for $38.25. And then you take that, and then, well, I would say swing trade. Learn swing trade, and then learn how to draw these blue lines. So let me zoom in just so you know why Bitcoin's dropping. I've said we're in a bear flag, okay? And we're right in here. I got to itch my nose. Apologize for that. And we're hanging on, just like the S&P 500 right now. And it's like, oh, right? Can I do this? Oh, I hang in there, buddy, until it drops into this gray zone, which it will. But no, Bravo, Bitcoin's going to change the world. I know it could. Yeah, the governments are not going to like it, and they're going to fight it because they're the ones that control your currency, and they don't want any competition. So just let you know, they're going to come after this like a criminal. But just in case you want to know why Bitcoin is dropping, it's because of that blue line. Why don't we head on over to the S&P 500 and take a look? Oh no. Why is why is it dropping? Let me get rid of percentage here. Let me move this so you can see it. See this? I drew this blue line. Goes all the way back to the last movement, way back here. See that? It could be a pixel off. But you come here, and it just tests, retests. Come down. Can you hold it? No. Bye-bye. Even with all of this going on, can you still make paper trading money from this? Yes. Lots of it. That's why I have a Bravo's watch list. I just swing. I'm like, well, here's one above the what? Now, this is SPY. You can trade this. But it's below the 200-day moving average. That's going that way. Oh, and just in case you would like me to reveal my crystal balls and show you how much farther you have to go. See, right above, but I'm going to get a haircut today. See that area? See where it's currently at? It's going to zip through there. Let me do this and draw that. It's going to go, oh no, and it's going to go right here. See that? There is no support in this area besides my hair. But if I do that, it's no support until you hit in my hair. That's it. So my apologies for that. Now we need to go on to Tesla. But before I do that, Russia says Ukraine war could go nuclear, right? If West what? Why do you have to do this to me, CBS? Now I have to click. No, they're all like threatening. But I just want you to know that they do have those nuclear. Yeah, got it. Nukes. They got them. And don't think that they won't push the little button. Kind of like the button that I have on little Jimmy, right? And if I push that button, what are we doing, Jimmy? Oh, yeah, you push that button. You better have your finger on that one. But now let's head over to Tesla and see if everything, we're going to scaffold here. Did I tell you about your highest high? Did I also tell you about when the founder or the founder's brother exit, right, the company? Should probably listen to them. That's about the day that they did. Highest high, lower high, lower high, lower high, lower high. See this? What's that? Oh my gosh. Exit here. Exit prior to earnings. So that way you don't have to get wrecked and go down here, which it's currently under the 200-day moving average at $800-something. And then coming back here, you see how we were in this channel? And then where do you put in the buy? Right there. That's your 200-day moving average. Go ahead. Get in there.
ride that all the way up to there. And I pinky promise all the markets, they all respect all of these lines. You just need to understand that.
Because if you think that this beauty pageant is based on fundamentals, you got me on the exit prior to earnings. You're like, I thought you don't do that. I thought we're only doing lines. Okay, that definitely lines around the little letter E. Yeah, exit there. This, it's all about this, right? These couple of lines. But also, I'm going to be very positive on Tesla. And let me tell you why. Has nothing to do with what they do, whether my wife drives one or not. You just got a severe beatdown. And guess what's going to happen? You're going to have a reversal. Johnny Bravo will put in the buy. We will ride. It will sell off. I will close my position, walk away with said paper trading money and buy paper vehicle. So hopefully everything that I said at the beginning, I'd said, why would Tesla drop? Why is this? Why is that? Why is Bitcoin? Why is the stock market? What about, where are we going in the future? All of these things. Can I get a subscribe? My gosh. I mean, unless you're getting this from mainstream media, then you knock yourself out. And I will knock myself out every single day just for you. Take advantage of that 197, and I will see you tomorrow.